So in this video on merchandise inventory, we're going to be looking at LIFO, last in, first out method of inventory valuation. So again, remember, as I stated in the earlier video about FIFO, this is a theoretical method or way of valuing your cost of goods sold and your ending inventory. It really has nothing to do necessarily with the physical flow of your inventory. It's just a way to value what we still have and what we've sold. So always keep that in mind. So let's look at this spreadsheet. It's very similar to the one we saw in the FIFO video, first in, first out, except now we're selling our goods under the theoretical method of last in, first out. So the stuff we sell is the newest stuff, the stuff that came in most recently. So here we have our ending inventory from June becomes our beginning inventory for July. So on July the 1st, we had one unit on hand, according to our spreadsheet here, and it cost us $40. On July the 5th, we purchased six items, and as prices typically do, they go up, so we paid $45 a piece for them. And now we have one item from beginning inventory on hand that cost us $40, and the six items that we just purchased at $45 each. So we have seven total items on hand that cost us a total of $310, which is the $40 plus the $270. Now, nothing up to this point is different from FIFO. But now on July the 15th, when we actually make a sale, this is where it becomes a little bit different. Under FIFO, we would go to the oldest stuff first, and we would go all the way back to beginning inventory for the month, and we would sell that stuff first. But now, under LIFO, we go to the newest stuff first. The newest stuff is that July the 5th purchase of six items. And we're selling four items on July the 15th, so that purchase on July the 5th actually is enough to cover this entire sale of four items. So we're assuming, theoretically, that we're selling four of those six items that cost us $45 a piece. Now keep in mind, we really have no idea from this chart how much we actually sold them for. This is just the cost. This is a cost record. It has nothing to do with the revenues. So keep that in mind as well. So now after selling these four items, we still have that one on hand from our beginning inventory, theoretically, and we still have two left from the July the 5th purchase at $45 a piece. So now we have an ending inventory of three items that cost a total of $130. Now on July the 26th, we bought seven more items. Again, prices are going up. $50 a piece, so a total of $350 for that purchase. So now we have the one item, again theoretically, from beginning inventory at $40. We have two items left from the July the 5th purchase, and now we have seven items that we just purchased on July the 26th. So what you need to start seeing here is it's very, very important that you stay organized with this information so that we know which items are going out next when we make a sale. So on July the 31st, we make a sale of eight items, and we go to our newest stuff first. The newest stuff is from that purchase on July the 26th of seven items. That is not enough to cover the whole sale of eight items, but we're going to sell all seven of those. So a cost of $350 for those seven items. Then we're going to have to go back to the July the 5th purchase and see if we have any of those left. And we do. We still have two of those. We only need one. So we're going to sell that item as well at a cost of $45. So a total cost of that one sale of eight items of $395. Now left on hand, we still have one item from beginning inventory way back from July the 1st. We still have that one. And we still have one item left from that July the 5th purchase of six items at $45. So we have a total ending inventory at the end of July of two items that have a total cost of $85. Our total cost of goods sold for the period would be the total column added up for cost of goods sold of 12 items that we sold of $575 and total purchases of 13 items at $620. So now I'd like for you to take a shot at it. I'm going to give you an example here. Assume that an arcade toy store bought and sold a line of dolls during December. Now, this is the same problem we used under the FIFO method. So you can go back, and once we have the solution here, you can go back and kind of compare the two. But I'd like for you to compute the cost of ending inventory and the cost of goods sold under LIFO. And then once you get that computed, we'll come back and look at it together. So push pause on your player. We'll come back in a second and talk about it together. Okay, so what you should have found is ending inventory of $90, cost of goods sold of $275 total, and purchases of $225. Now, what I want us to talk about here for a second is which method, if you go back and compare this with your FIFO that you did in an earlier video, which is going to result in the higher cost of goods sold and why? Well, if you look back at the FIFO method, if you watched that video, you should find that the cost of goods sold under LIFO is higher than under FIFO. Why is that? Well, it's because prices rise. So if prices continually rise, which we anticipate them doing, then if we sell, theoretically, the newest stuff first, then that would be the most expensive stuff that we're holding in our inventory. If we sell the most expensive stuff first, then that means our cost of goods sold will be higher under LIFO than it will be under FIFO. That means we're also going to show a lower net income under LIFO, therefore, or a lower operating income, therefore reducing our taxes that we have to pay. But also keep in mind, this also shows a lower net income to our stakeholders, which may or may not necessarily look good to them. Don't forget, if you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up, and questions and comments are always welcome.